Ex-President of the Nubuwwat Council. Honorable Muhammad Akhtar Hussain, Bangladesh Association of Hong Kong. Honorable Mr. Munsif Khan, New Star Globe Limited. Honorable Mr. Zafrullah, President of Indian Muslim Association. And Honorable Mr. Sayyuddin, Chairman of the Incorporated Trustee of Hong Kong. Of Islamic community from Hong Kong. Khatme Nubuwwat ke ustad ikram sir ko dab.
Oh. Alims
Next, I will take this opportunity to invite Brother Professor Akhtar to brief us on the work of Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council on Limited.
The talent of Mudassir is legendary. He is not the only one Khatme Nubuwwat has got. There are many like him, but his knowledge is very remarkable. So I also congratulate his teacher, Hafiz Muhammad Ali, from County. I'm here to throw some light on the work of Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council Limited. So first of all, I welcome all the honorable guests, especially His Excellency Honorable Saud Al-Masayed to our Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council headquarters. Welcome, sir. To give few highlights about number one, Islam in Hong Kong, and then the work of this particular organization. Islam in Hong Kong became evident around the time the British arrived in Hong Kong. In 1841, when Captain Elliot planted the British flag on Hong Kong Island, he very famously declared, "Hong Kong is a barren rock." That same year, in the Legislative Council of Hong Kong, petitioned the Governor in Council to establish, to ask him for some place for Muslims to worship. The efforts continued, and then by 1855 the first mosque was opened by the Muslims of Hong Kong. Thereafter more efforts continued, and they all culminated in the most visible Muslim icon in Hong Kong, the badge of every Muslim in Hong Kong, the Kowloon Mosque, opened in 1896. This mosque was there during World War I and World War II. After the World War II, more and more Muslims from the Indian subcontinent arrived, and the need grew for more services. The Muslims decided to refurbish the mosque, and a fresh new icon was reconstructed in 1984. Imam Suleiman from South India was the first Imam of Kowloon Mosque after its reopening in 1984. And a short while later, the management of invited Honorable Qari Tayyab, Qasmi to be the Imam there. Qari Sahib offered his services in Kowloon Mosque for several years, and many of you might recall the most notable among them was writing of Imam Taba in 1995. In 1995, Imam Sabayan from Kaaba arrived in Hong Kong for the very first time. Muslims in Hong Kong got the opportunity to meet the Imam of Kaaba, whom you can't even meet when you go on Hajj. The same year, Qari Sahib also established this particular organization, Khatme Nubuwwat. Well, at that time, movement, and as you are well aware that 3 years ago in 2010 that society was changed into an incorporated body, and today it's known as Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council Limited of Hong Kong. This particular Muslim organization is one of the two major organizations serving thousands of Muslim children needs. Board of Trustees and Khatme Nubuwwat together manage these children go to the madrasas of Board of Trustees and of Khatme Nubuwwat to receive religious instruction. Today, Khatme Nubuwwat has got 8 centers in various areas of Hong Kong, and in a few weeks' time, inshallah, on New Year Day, a 9th center will also be open, and you will be informed of that in due course. 19 teachers are serving these different madrasas. 1,400 boys and girls receive instruction annually, and as you can know today, there are 150 graduates who have completed their Holy Quran in the madrasas of Khatme Nubuwwat. Plus, there are 10 more who have recited the whole Quran by heart. Qari Tayyab, towards the end of 20th century, in the late 90s, he had one concern about the growing Muslim population in Hong Kong, that when they need to go for Hajj to arrange their visa, it used to be quite a painful process, because sometimes he had to go to Beijing, sometimes to Bangkok to process the visas. Because as everybody knows, the Saudi Arabia have any diplomatic presence in Hong Kong. Qari Tayyab Sahab collected 3,000 signatures from Muslims of the subcontinent mainly, and submitted them to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Riyadh. And this exercise was repeated 2 times. Probably because of this and other efforts, the ministry got convinced, and a decade ago the Saudi Arabia consulate was established in Hong Kong, and now everybody knows that it is easy to apply for Hajj and Umrah visas. Khatme Nubuwwat, in tandem with Board of Trustees, is committed to providing religious education to children in all areas of Hong Kong. And alhamdulillah, it is happening. Furthermore, there is one other aspect that some of you might have already noted after coming in the hall today, that Khatme Nubuwwat students, they are extremely talented. One example you have already seen. I want to mention another thing, that in Hong Kong, for the past 11 years, there has been a religious competition, a Quran competition going on, known by the name of Islam Quranic competition. Every year, students from 11 Muslim organizations comprising 30 madrasas take part in that competition. This year, in January 2013, out of six winners, five were from Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council. Three boys, first, second, third, and two girls. They will be presented to you later today. The achievements of this organization in so short time are a testament to the efforts of Qari Tayyab and his team of those 19 teachers I mentioned. We are always grateful to other organizations, especially the Board of Trustees and to the consulate, various consulates, especially the Consulate General of Saudi Arabia, for their cooperation in all the matters, including today's one. And we anticipate that we will continue to receive these cooperations from the consulate and from other Muslim organizations all over Hong Kong, because everyone is having the same objective to educate the next generation. I wouldn't take much more time because we have got a lengthy program in front of us. So thank you for your coming today. Please enjoy the ceremony. It's once a year. Thank you.
I would like to call upon Brother Javed Mahmoud, Vice Chairman of the Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council Limited, to give a welcome address.
Assalamu alaikum. His Excellency Honorable Mr. Saud Al-Musayyib, Honorable Mr. Ifti Bachchan Al-Nizam, Honorable Mr. Thomas Mahmoud, Honorable Mr. Sampion, Honorable parents, guests, and dear students, a very good afternoon to all of you. I welcome you to the headquarters of Khatme Nubuwwat Islamic Council Committee, the most dynamic organization in Hong Kong. As Mr. Pervez has already described for organization to you, I shall proceed to discuss only today's event. Graduation ceremony is a permanent fixture in our academic calendar. This year there are 150 graduates that we shall shortly present to you. Amongst them, there are 10 students who have recited the whole Quran by heart. Towards the end of the program, our resident scholar and the chief guest of honor will award the customary treatment to these 10 office in the Dastar Gandhi ceremony. I would like to express our sincere appreciation to Honorable Mr. Saud Al-Saud and all other honorable guests for ensuring the success of our annual graduation ceremony. I heartily welcome all of you to join the late lunch after the ceremony. Without consuming any more time, I declare 2012-2013 graduation ceremony started. Thank you.
Now we come to the climax of the afternoon. May I call upon Honorable Jang Zed Khan, ex-president of the Nubuwwat Islamic Council Limited, to present a certificate to our graduates. Thank you. Adil Khan.
Sakib Adil Khan.
Thank you.
by myself. Sana'ullah. Adnan. Muhammad Husnain.
Girls from Pachan Madrasa, Amna Bibi. ये बच्चे अपने बहनों की सिखी दे रहे हैं। मरियम बीबी, हनीफा बीबी, अजीफा बीबी, हुमैरा बीबी, मदिया खान, Muhammad Usman, Jabbar. Abdul Rahim.
Guest of honor.
unprinted material, or for that any unprinted material that the vast sea of knowledge contained in the Holy Quran. So when the Muslims read Quran on earth, when the day begins in Kirbani Islands, Muslims are reading the Quran. As the sun inches westwards, Muslims in New Zealand are reading the Quran. Then in Japan, Taiwan, Korea, Hong Kong, Australia and Thailand are reading. People in Dubai, Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Morocco, France, England, Brazil and America continue to read the Quran. Finally, it's time again in the next day for the few Muslims of Kiribati Islands to read Quran. Thus, in 365 days, 1.4 billion Muslims are reading the Quran 24/7. Why are Muslims reading this book non-stop? Because it is something that is supposed to be done daily. It helps erase our sins, purify our hearts, protects us from all evil and danger. And in other things, they need help me. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider of all this. He is the one that purifies our heart every time we hear and read the Quran. It is also done so they could memorize it. I would say that the finest act of power that a person can do is to recite the Quran and to follow what Allah has commanded and to stay away from what Allah has forbidden. And from a personal experience with the Quran for over 10 years, I am convinced that the Quran has a great deal of influence on the human personality. There are some important messages written in the Quran for all humankind. These are as follows. First, respect and honor all human beings irrespective of their religion, color, race, sex, language, status, property, birth, profession, job, and so on. Second, talk straight to the point without any ambiguity or deception. Third, choose the best words to speak and say them in the best possible way. Fourth, do not shout. Speak politely, keeping your voice low. Fifth, always speak the truth. Sixth, do not confound truth with falsehood. Seventh, say with your mouth what is in your heart. Eighth, speak in a civilized manner, in a language that is recognized by the society and is commonly used. Ninth, when you voice an opinion, be judged, even if it is against the relative. Tenth, do not be a bragging booster. Do not talk, listen, or do anything vague. I can guarantee you, my dear brothers, that every verse you read, comprehend, and memorize can modify your life. Imagine who reads and memorizes the Quran in his heart. No doubt that reciting Quranic verses, understanding them and listening them, enhances the culture and reveals a new personality. That's because the Quran contains foundations and the basis to build a personality. So, to conclude, reading the Holy Quran purifies one's heart and helps you in every aspect of your life. Instead of playing games and watching useless videos while traveling, you may recite verses of the Quran and read it. May Allah bless you all and make your brothers love Quran as they love their loved ones. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Excellency Saud Al Musaid, Vice Consul, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, presents and dedicate to our Hafiz students.
Thank you.
taken up by our girls. The top position was captured by Zen Masses. In the second position went to Amna Bibi from Tokin Madrasa. Thank you.
Thank you. This is the end of the Dastarbandi session.
Adopted by others, the reward of all others people who are starting the good deeds, good actions, the reward will be given to the one who has started in the first. So inshallah, the reward will be given to Qari sir. So all of us, whether they are graduated from Good Afternoon Madrasa or any other madrasa, or Khatme Nubuwwat Madrasa, inshallah, there will be some share for Qari sir. Qari sir ke liye inshallah. Aur wo hadith jo maine aapke samne tilawat ki usko suna ke khatam mein apni baat Huzur sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne ishaara farmaya ke qiyamah tak meri ummat ka koi na koi giroh aisa rahega jisko Allah ki ta'eed hasil rahegi aur duniya ki mukhalifat usko nuksan nahi de sakegi aur Allah un logo ke zariye apne deen ko qiyamah tak zinda rakhega. Chatai pe baithenge, suliyon pe bhi chadhenge, takleefein bhi uthayenge, galiyan bhi sunenge, lekin deen ka kaam wo karte rahenge. Ye kisi khandan ke sath khaas nahi, kisi mulk ke sath khaas nahi, kisi ilake ke sath khaas nahi. Jab Allah jisse chahta hai kaam le leta hai. Aise bhi hamare buzurg guzre hain ke unke walidain mamooli mazdoor the. Aise bhi hamare buzurg aur asraf guzre hain ke unke walid hajjam the. Aise bhi hamare buzurg aur asraf guzre hain. Aaj hame ye sharaf haasil hai aur unka naam lete hue hum fakhr mehsoos karte hain ke hamare silsile sanad mein, sanad e hadith mein naam hai mufti ki Faizullah Dehlvi ka, Hazrat Maulana Ashraf Ali Khan ki rahmatullah alayh ka, Maulana Muhammad Qasim Nanavati rahmatullah alayh ka, Shah Waliullah rahmatullah alayh ka. Aap unke aba o ajdad ko dekh lein, koi ye aba o ajdad se deen ka kaam nahi kar rahe the, lekin Allah ne jab intikhab kiya to ek mazdoor ke bacche ko muntakhab karke vilayat ke ala tareeq maqam pe bitha diya. Ye Allah ki deen hai, to Allah ne ये जो सिलसिला दीन की हिफाजत का किया है, मैं कहता हूँ औलाद अल्लाह देने वाला है, खेती अल्लाह देने वाला है, लेकिन औलाद उस वक्त देता है जब मियाँ और बीवी का ताल्लुक कायम होता है. सबब बनते हैं मियाँ बीवी का ताल्लुक. अल्लाह ताला फल देता है, दरख्त उगाता है, लेकिन सबब बन जाता है एक किसान तबीज डालना. तो अल्लाह ने अपनी किताब की हिफाजत का खुद अहद किया है, खुद वादा किया है कि वो अपनी किताब की हिफाजत और अपने पैगंबर को दिए हुए दीन की हिफाजत करेगा. लेकिन अल्लाह सबब बना लेता है इन असातिज़ाए किराम को और कारी साहब जैसी शख्सियत को. और ये सबब अल्लाह ताला मुझे और आपको बना ले, ये मेरे लिए यही एहसास काफी है. जैसे हजरत अली ने मुर्तजा फरमाया करते थे, लना इल्मु वलिल जुहाल मालू, कि हमें हमारे लिए यही इज्जत काफी है कि अल्लाह ने हमें इल्म से निस्बत दी है और बाकी लोगों को दुनिया से ताल्लुक दिया है. हमारे लिए यही शर्त काफी है कि अल्लाह हमें इल्म के साथ वाबस्ता रखे और इल्म की खिदमत अल्लाह हमारी कबूल फरमाए. बाबा
Thank you, Hazrat Mufti Sahab. We will definitely treasure your words of wisdom. Next, I would like to invite Uncle Muhammad Ijaz to give all the thanks.
Saudi Arabia.
express our gratitude to His Excellency Honorable Saud Al-Husayn. Now I would like to request Honorable Qari Tayyab Qasmi Sahib to present a memento to His Excellency Honorable Saud Al-Husayn.
Teachers, male teachers first. Could I invite
Qari Muhammad Awais.
Thank you.
तैयब बेगम नुमान तैयब Daughter of Qari, Muhammad Nawaz. Chacha Nawaz sahab, Bishop Sahib. Maksud Hussain. Thank you.
کوئی دستار بنتی ہے کوئی چیز سے سفر کرتا آپ حضرات سے دعا کی درخواست بھی ہے دعا کر میرا اس والے کو عمل بنا میرا ان شاء اللہ جانا ہوگا 24, 25, 26, 27, 28 دسمبر سارے میرے سنسپری کا پروگرام ہے اس کی دستار بندی میں بھی حاضری ہے میرا وہاں بیان بھی ہے کہ سارے مدد سے سنسپری کا یہ مفتی صاحب کہہ رہے تھے ایک شعر مجھے یاد آیا یہ چمن یوں ہی رہے گا اور ہزاروں جانور سب اپنی اپنی بولیاں بول کر اڑ جائیں ایک دن آئے گا ہم بھی چلے جائیں لیکن یہ صدقہ جاریہ ہمیشہ کے لیے رہے گا جب تک بچے قرآن پڑھتے رہیں گے پڑھاتے رہیں گے اللہ پاک قبروں میں ہمیں ثواب دیتا رہے گا بورڈ آف ٹرسٹی ختم نبوت ہانگ کانگ میں جو یہ خدمت کر رہی ہیں اللہ کے قرآن کی ان کے لیے بھی دعا کرے اللہ ان کی خدمات کو قبول کرے اور مزید ان کے لیے اللہ پاک خدمات کرنے کی توفیق دے دے مسجد ابراہیم ابھی ہفتہ 10 دن پہلے ہانگ کانگ میں کھلی مسلمانوں کے لیے بڑے مبارک کی بات ہے میرے زبیر بھائی وہاں کے امام بھی بیٹھے ہیں میرے اسحاق بھائی اس مسجد کو چلانے والے بھی بیٹھے ہیں بھی دعائیں ہیں اللہ ان کی اس مسجد کو ہماری مسجد کو اللہ آباد و شاد رکھے جو لوگ مسجدوں کو آباد کرتے ہیں اللہ ان کے گھروں کو آباد کرتے ہیں حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا یا قرآن پڑھنے والے پر ہو یا قرآن پڑھانے والے پر ہو یا ان دونوں کی خدمت کرنے والے بنو تیسری جگہ کوئی نہیں چوتھی جگہ کوئی نہیں یا قرآن پڑھو یا پڑھاؤ یا ان کی خدمت کرو یہ مدارس آپ حضرات کی خدمات سے حلال کی کمائی سے چلتے ہیں مسجد آباد یہ پروگرام ہم صرف اس لیے کراتے ہیں بچوں کی حوصلہ افزائی کی ہو ماں باپ کی حوصلہ افزائی ہو اساتذہ کی ہو اور اصل چیز یہ ہے کہ آپ حضرات کو ذہنی تسلی ہو کہ ہم جو اللہ کے نام پہ 10, 20, 50, 100 ڈالر دیتے ہیں آیا وہ جائز جگہ پہ لگ رہا ہے آیا اس کا کوئی ریزلٹ ہے اس کا کوئی نتیجہ ہے میں الحمدللہ اللہ کے گھر میں کھڑا ہوں ذہنی طور پر قلبی طور پر مطمئن ہوں کہ انشاءاللہ قیامت کے دن ہمارا میرا پار ہو جائے گا قرآن کی برکت اور سب آپ کو میں صرف ایک بات کہنے کے لیے کھڑا ہوا تھا میں نے 2-3 باتیں کہہ دی آپ کو پتا ہے یہ ہمارے مدرسے جتنے ہیں ہم لوگ چندے کو کرتے ہیں ختم نبوت کے ممبران سے جو ہماری کم از کم 100 ڈالر منتھلی ممبرشپ کی فیس ہے زیادہ جتنی کسی کی توفیق ہے نوجوان ساتھی ختم نبوت کے ممبر ہیں جن کے داموں سے ہمارے مدرسے چلتے ہیں میری آپ حضرات سے صرف اتنی درخواست ہے جو ساتھی ممبر نہیں ہیں جذبہ رکھتے ہیں 100, 200 ڈالر آج کوئی چیز نہیں آپ کو فارم ابھی مہیا ہے ممبر بن کے جائیں جو نہیں بنے تاکہ آپ کے لیے یہ سلسلہ جاریہ زندگی میں بھی اور مرنے کے بعد بھی جاری ہے یہ ساتھی آپ کو بانٹ رہے ہیں اگر ممبرشپ والے ساتھی کھڑے ہیں تو جو ساتھی ممبر نہیں ہیں وہ ختم نبوت کے ممبر بن کے جائیں ٹھیک ہے بھائی
مفتی محمد شعیب دعا مفتی صاحب دعا کریں
اس ہانگ کانگ کی سرزمین پر جو احسان ہے اسے الفاظ میں بیان نہیں کیا جا سکتا میں صرف ایک بات کرتا ہوں میرے والد صاحب اور حضرت قاری صاحب ایک ہی مادر علمی کے طالب علم رہے میں جب چھوٹا تھا اس وقت حضرت قاری صاحب کے الفاظ اور نام مجھے یاد ہیں بڑے بھائی کچھ دن پہلے پچھلے سال یہاں آئے تھے حضرت قاری صاحب سے ملاقات ہوئی تھی الحمدللہ دنیا بھر کے اندر حضرت قاری صاحب کا ایک بلند و بالا نام ہے करते हुए एक बात करता हूँ। उम्मीद है इंशाअल्लाह ताला तिफले मकतब की इस बात को सुनकर हजरत कारी साहब दस्त शफ़त दराज फरमाएंगे। वो बात ये है, 1400 तालिब इल्मों का एक नेटवर्क है इस खत्मे नबुव्वत। मेरी मालूमात के मुताबिक इतना बड़ा नेटवर्क ना तो हांगकांग में है, ना आसपास की रियासतों जापान थाईलैंड चाइना, इतना बड़ा नेटवर्क कहीं पर नहीं। कुरान पाक का सबसे बड़ा नेटवर्क खत्मे नबुव्वत की मरहूम मन्नत है। अल्लाह ताला हजरत कारी साहब का साया कादेर हम पर कायम और दायम रखे। मगर एक बात, और मुझे यकीन है हजरत कारी साहब अनकरीब उस सिलसिले को शुरू करेंगे और वो होगा लाजिम, और वो ये है कि इस पूरे खित्ते में कुरान पाक के साथ साथ अब तक आलिम कोर्स का मदरसा नहीं है। यहां से तलबा लंदन जा रहे हैं, यहां से तलबा अफ्रीका जा रहे हैं, यहां से तलबा पाकिस्तान हिंदुस्तान जा रहे हैं। हजरत कारी साहब ने जब से ऐलान फरमाया कि उनका बेटा 25 तारीख को अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह दस्तार फजीलत से उसको नवाजा जाएगा, हमारे दिल से दुआ है और मैं कारी साहब का दस्त और उनका पुश्तीबान और उनका खादिम की हैसियत से मैं ये दरख्वास्त पेश कर रहा हूँ। मुझे उम्मीद है कि इंशाअल्लाह ताला जल्द ही हमारी आंखें ये देखेंगी कि इस हांगकांग की सरजमीन पे आलिम कोर्स के मदरसे का सिलसिला शुरू हो जाएगा। अल्लाह ताला हम सब का हाल क्यों नासिर हो। मैं दुआ के लिए बुलाया गया हूँ, तकदीर के लिए नहीं बुलाया गया हूँ। माजरत चाहता हूँ, अपने अल्फाज में ज्यादा लिए हैं। वह आखिर दावा अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन।
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन।
ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.
اللهم ارحم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك من الإيمان. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا ورزقا واسعا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وشفاء عاجلا. اللهم انا نسالك من الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم انا نعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم اجعل القران لقلوبنا ضياء ولاسقامنا دواء ولابصارنا جلاء ولذنوبنا ممحصا ومن النار مخلصا. اللهم ذكرنا منه وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته اناء الليل واطراف النهار. يا الله يا الله في جسم السلا يا حق جل رها ہے يا الله اس کو قائم و دائم فرما. يا الله اس کے فیوز کو پوری دنیا کے اندر پھیلا دے. يا الله حضرت قاری صاحب کا سایہ دادے قائم و دائم فرما. يا الله ان کی خدمات کو پوری دنیا کے اندر پھیلا دے. يا الله کی طرف سے فرض کفایہ ادا ہے، یا اللہ اسے قبول فرما لیجیے. یا اللہ ان اکابر کی موجودگی میں مجھ جیسا ایک چھوٹا سا طالب علم دعا کرا رہا ہے، یا اللہ یہ ہاتھ اٹھائے گئے ہیں، یا اللہ ان ہاتھوں کو قبول فرما لے. یا اللہ اخلاص عطا فرما دے. یا اللہ تکبر اور ریاکاری کے جراثیم سے بچا دے. یا اللہ ہم سب کو قرآن کا دل دادا بنا دے، سچا عاشق رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم بنا دے،
ہمارے گناہوں کو معاف فرما، صغیرہ کبیرہ اور خفیہ اعلانیہ گناہوں کو معاف فرما.
ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. صلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين.
بھائی ساتھی اپنی اپنی جگہ پہ بیٹھے رہے، خدمت والے ساتھی کھڑے ہو جائیں. کھانا ہے آپ حضرات کے لیے، اطمینان سے بیٹھ رہے کھائیں، اس کے بعد جانے کی اجازت ہے. حضرات اطمینان سے بیٹھے ساتھی بھائی، خدمت والے آ جائیں. Thank you. बच्चों को उनके माँ बाप को मेरी तरफ से बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद। एक बच्चा हाफिज होता है अगर वो इल्म अमल पे लेता है तो पूरे खानदान के मुशर्रफ का जरिया बन जाता है, इल्म अमल पे रहे तो पूरे खानदान के मुशर्रफ का जरिया। ये